Today's lesson was based on a couple of objectives or state standards, one being that the students would plan and investigate a simple investigation. They would also hit a few GLEs for force of motion, which was the GLE that showed that the motion of an object can be changed or stopped when it is met with another force. So from the beginning of the lesson, we started with the engage by reading the book Sheep in a Jeep, and then the students did a T-chart with examples from the book, the force and the motion that they saw in the book. So what we're gonna do now is make this T-chart. It's not necessary for you to put in these lines. If you just wanna make your T, put force on one side, motion on the other, and then use your notebook paper lines to go ahead and finish the rest of your chart. Who can tell me what a force is? Dakota.
Force is gravity or push or pull.
Okay. Dakota says force is gravity or push or pull. Gabe.
Friction.
Okay. Friction could have something to do with force. Timothy.
Air pressure.
Okay, I'm not going to tell you right now what a force is. You're going to investigate that in our lab checkpoint. After the engagement part of the lesson, they went into the four steps of exploration. They had a beginning setup where they looked at the setup and decided what exactly that was going to be able to do for them. In part B, they had to change the heights of the ramp. In part C, they changed the heights of the ramp and then added some sandpaper to see what that would do to the distance that the Jeep would travel. And then in part D, they unhooked the tape, which was the sheep's seat belt, to see what would happen to the Jeep when it hit a force. Did you just have to do it once? Okay, yeah, you just did it once, so let's see. Oh, yeah. Okay, so go ahead and put down underneath question D, what happened when the sheep hit the book, and why do you think that? So I don't know, you tell me. When Jacob said when it hit the book, it fell off because the book was a what? That stopped the Jeep. Now, this leads you to question two. Why is it important to wear a seatbelt in a moving car based on what you just did? Kaylee, what do you think? Why is it important to wear a seatbelt based on what you just did? A little bit louder because I can't hear you very good. You said if you didn't have your seatbelt on and you were in an accident.
You can get hurt.
How?
You could like fly across the car.
You could fly across the car just like the Jeep did when we removed his seatbelt. Good job. After they did the exploration, they would do the explanation also by creating a poster that would show what happened in A, B, C, and D steps of the lab. Then we would move on to read a section on force and motion, and they would have some word cards that they would use to make sentences before reading the nonfiction selection on force and motion. Then after, they would see if they wanted to change any of the sentences they've made with the word cards. The elaboration section would be when they created an invention that would slow the movement of the sheep. Somehow they would have to use whatever items that I gave them to create something that would keep the sheep from falling quickly. They needed to slow down the motion. And that pretty much covers all the E's of this lab. We would do an evaluation probably after we've finished about 3 days of this with a force and motion quiz. In the elementary setting, there's so many things that have to be taught that sometimes science gets pushed to the side. And that's unfortunate because children love to explore. They like to get their hands into stuff, to get dirty, to try stuff and see what's going on. They would rather do it than have you tell them this is what is going to happen. And with science, you always need to let the students know that nothing works right. This, you know, we could do this 15 times and we could have 15 different outcomes from it. And just that they get to actually try it and see, oh, well, we did have a problem there. I need to try that again. The little kids, I think, can get the basic concepts, like they can sort things and they can put things in groups. When you get to an older age, they can really understand what a centimeter is, how to use the tools. And I think that's great at this age that we put that in their hands, because believe it or not, before I really started doing the 5E's and getting into science, I had kids at this level that did not know how to use a ruler, did not know how to use a measuring cup or a measuring spoon. And then when you give them a graduated cylinder, that's just too much for them. So I think if you start now, by the time they get to those classes that they really need in high school, biology, chemistry, the physical science, the earth sciences, they can really move them up to that level that they need to for higher education, if we've laid the groundwork here at the elementary.